Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome. You know, the team at Fiat has been very much looking forward to this presentation because today, March 1st, is a real milestone for our family. A growing family, actually, with five new babies I wanted to meet, a spotty baby named 500S, the Tipo twins, Hatch and Station, the adorable sister, 124 Spider, and even a cousin, the Fiat fullback. I would say a healthy baby that will need a big stroller. Speaking of stroller, and on a more personal note, March 1st is also a milestone for my own family. Really, today has been on my private radar for the last 9 months, because believe it or not, March 1st happens to also be my wife's due date. The reason why I bring this up, this detail up, is that unlike my wife and I, today Fiat delivers more than a baby. We deliver the next iteration of the brand. Because you know, unlike the Family Guy, what's really exciting for the brand guy is not expanding his family. It's not adding nameplates at any cost. No, it is adding value. It's adding uniqueness to the brand. And Fiat has been unique for the last 117 years. You know what makes Fiat unique? It is its ability to play at the same time in two arenas. On the left of the stand, simplicity, functionality, and accessibility, the typical post-war Fiat. On the right, design, aspiration, fashion icons, the Dolce Vita Fiat. Fiat has been playing this duality for more than a century, and today, duality, you know, is everywhere. It takes a fashion business, for example. They created their own duality because they wanted to reach wider and grow faster. And the car industry has also become pretty bipolar. Look at who has gained volume in the last 5 years and who has lost. The aspirational, emotional brands have definitely been growing, and the value for money brands too have been growing. Both are a good way to go. But in the middle, the mainstream, this is where you go home. So where should we be? Emotional or functional? Well, the beauty is Fiat does not have to pick a side. Our dual culture, our heritage provides us with the legitimacy to pick them both. All we have to do is distillate the essence of Fiat and purify our double DNA. On the black side of the stand, aspiration, the culture of Italian seduction, and on the white side, the culture of function for money, as I call it. By the way, this shot, you know, the bird's eye view of the stand, this is better than any slide. It is the physical representation of where our dual culture has led us. Two sides, two souls, two colors, but no border. It is one brand. So today I'd like to show you how these two sides dialogue with one another, how they feed one another, how they complete one another. So let's use the map of the stand as a speech report and start a journey from 500, the heart of Fiat's aspirational style. 500 in three numbers, number one of the A segment, 1.7 million units worldwide, 80% of which outside of Italy. So these 500s behind me, by the way, are the completely redesigned 500s presented last year. And in 2016, there is something even newer, the S. An S that stands for sporty, obviously, but also for special. I mean, on top of all these features introduced last July, 500S has special front and rear bumpers and rear spoiler, special wheels, and special interior appointments. And S also stands for sales. Look at this. The previous generation S was worth 20% of the mix, purely incremental, appealing to a new, younger, and more masculine customer. And last, S stands for sound. 500S is the first vehicle in the world to have the Apple trifecta. I mean, CarPlay, Apple Music, and Beats Audio all combined. This is a perfect harmonization of Apple approach to sound quality from the source to the end product. Well, as we said, 500 leads the A segment in Europe. Great. So the question is, who is second? Don't look across the auto show. Just look across our stand. Here you are, Panda,
only Panda is second to 500. Two very unique siblings with the same family name, Fiat. Together, they embody two different ways to look at the segment: emotion or practicality. But what really matters is that together, they own a third of the egg segment in Europe. You see, duality pays off. Well, the Panda we brought here is a little bit special. Are you familiar with Kung Fu Panda? Of course you are. Well, that other panda happens to be pretty much like ours. Cute, capable, and on its last, only third generation. So our designers, together with DreamWorks, created this one-of-a-kind panda, which will be auctioned to benefit Conservation International and preserve the habitat of the other panda. Like any panda, ours loves white. It is its natural habitat for a functional lineup. But a Fiat panda has a special power, transcending from practical to aspirational. I mean, when you add best-in-class 4x4 capability, the cool factor becomes so evident that it also can live in a more aspirational habitat, spotted here in black. Because like everything on Earth, Fiat has a yin and it has a yang, aspiration and function. As I said before, they interact, they dialogue, they feed off each other. I mean, look at the word aspirational. Did you see it? Did you see rational? Here you are. It takes some rational even when you sell aspiration. The best example, 500L. It embodies a practical side of aspiration. The right screen is about style. And on the left, it's about best-in-class efficiency, space efficiency. You see, it is at the same time cool and capable. And with this promise, we approach 300,000 units sold in 3 years. And we lead the segment in Europe. And next to 500L is 500X, a different blend of design, capability, and iconic DNA. And another success in the making, with already 100,000 units sold in the first 12 months. Now, take the word functional. Did you see the touch of fun? At Fiat, we love the concept of fun in functional, like the Panda Cross. Is it functional? Yes. Is it also fun? Absolutely. So we felt that we had a license to further explore this territory. Remember the big stroller? Let's discover what's inside. This is a Fiat Fullback. It looks like Panda's Papa Bear. It makes a bold statement about your lifestyle. Maybe am I spending too much time in the US, a country you know, where a man is judged by the size of its pickup truck. But why not in Europe too? Well, perhaps not that bold of a statement, but there is still room to keep blending functionality and fun. The Fullback will debut with Fiat Professional in the second part of the year, and it will then play full-time within our passenger car lineup starting in 2017 season. I love the idea that even though the Fullback is almost 50% bigger than a Panda, they are brand mates. They carry the same philosophy. And to make Fullback become the official car to do whatever you want, actually the official truck to do whatever you want, we are joining hands with Mopar to create the perfect pickup to fit your needs. You can go surf, fish, ski, ride a bike, or kayak, whatever. You have total freedom of choice. Clearly, this is a form of freedom that relies on function. But when you speak of Fiat, there is another side of freedom, right? Freedom as a feeling, freedom as an emotion. Well, there is one Fiat that definitely embodies that other side of freedom, 124 Spider. It was born in 1966. It exported the art of Italian driving to the world, and this year marks its 50th birthday. Ladies and gentlemen, the icon is back. The new Fiat 124 Spider, style, performance, and substance. A substance that starts with the winning formula of the 60s. Front longitudinal engine, rear wheel drive, great weight to power ratio, low center of gravity, and short throw shifting. Our new Spider takes everything that makes a convertible visceral and exciting and amps it up. How? First, with a platform that was born to be a roadster. This is pretty unique. Then with some venom, a 140 horsepower, 1.4 turbo multi-air engine with 240 newton meter, the best in class weight to torque ratio, and 0 to 100 in 7.5 seconds. That's the heart of the Spider. It's built in Italy and full of Italian spirit. So what does this mean to you? Fun and confidence. It means enjoy the road in complete control. The whole objective here is to make any average driver feel like a great driver and every great driver feel like a champion. So we also made a massive commitment to safety because we want every driver, seasoned or not, to safely enjoy the ride. But 124 Spider is also the epitome of the emotional side of the brand. So as you see in the slide and more importantly in the car, we made quality and craftsmanship very visible and tangible. But what is the most visible thing in a Spider? The top, obviously. Well, ours is the quickest and the easiest to operate. Look at this. You can literally go topless with the flick of the wrist. It's never been easier to feel free. Free like a bird.
Free falling from the skyline. Nobody gonna stop my shine. Feel the wind when I'm blowing right by. Speed in my hand, I'm a controller of time. 'Cause I'm free like a bird. Whether or not I'm wanting to, I know I'm wanting. I have to pay back home. 'Cause I'm free like a bird. I'm wanting to, I'm not a one day, I have to be my own home.
We all want to be as free as the birds. But maybe the birds want to be as free as us. The all-new Fiat 124 Spider. More fun than flying.
'Cause I'm free like a bird.
You see, there will be wind in your feathers and romance in the air. Because we all know, roadsters excite all the senses. All senses, well, but one, the common sense. Common sense typically lives on the other side of the stand, the functional, practical space. So how does Fiat speak to common sense? With Fiat Tipo, actually with more Fiat Tipos. This is how we are re-entering the C segment, the second biggest in Europe and the single largest for the business and fleet markets. And trust me, this one is not about romance, it's totally about purpose. So let's leave the high-flying pitch behind. Here we need a very grounded mindset, practicality, comfort, and price. The video that is running behind me is a launch commercial of a Tipo in Italy. The numbers don't need translation. Tipo is built around the promise that you don't need much to get a lot. Don't get me wrong though, Tipo is not a sweep-down car. It offers what's really relevant to the customer, nothing more, nothing less, and delivers an outstanding value for money equation. An equation, by the way, that goes even beyond price and feature. Tipo has best-in-class total cost of ownership. Low maintenance costs, low repair costs, is cheap to own and frugal to maintain. And let me add another one. Simple to choose, simple to buy. No long catalog of customization here and a very lean powertrain lineup. It's packaged to precisely provide what the segment wants and needs. Because to win the segment, you need to check some basic boxes: economy, practicality, comfort, and style. With the sedan, we have a winner. In less than a quarter, we already hit the 20,000 mark. So how to check more boxes? With two new Tipos. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Fiat Tipo, Hatch and Wagon.
People searching what we got and still can never find. Feel I win the lotto from the day I made your mind. Some are searching happiness, I look for dollar sign. But honestly, my girl, you make me happy every time.
I'm not rich, but I live like a millionaire. You know I live like a millionaire. You know I live like I ain't got a care in the world. But I do. I care about me and you. I care about me and you. I care about right and wrong. So I got to be strong.
As you heard in the song, you don't need to be rich to feel rich. This is the spirit of Tipo. It's about value, but also about values. And Tipo is now a perfect family portrait of three, each of them with their own identity, purpose, and customer. Three more reasons to buy one. You take a sedan with striking roominess, best-in-class legroom space, best-in-class shoulder space, and you give it two more body styles that celebrate space efficiency even further. Class-leading boot capacity on all versions, and with a fully reconfigurable trunk of the wagon, more flexibility. And while we watch the demo, this is also an opportunity for me to introduce you to these four ladies from our engineering team who have been instrumental to the project. Grazie ragazze. Space efficiency, but also amazing fuel efficiency with a second generation multi-jet 120 horsepower. Imagine 3.7 liter of diesel per 100 kilometers, the same fuel economy as a Fiat Panda. And last, the hatch and station have an evolved dashboard hosting a Uconnect 7-inch tablet-like display because technology and larger screens are now part of the expectations. You see, Tipo gives everyone, included the B-segment owner, an upgrade voucher to business class. This is how Tipo is true to the roots of Fiat, a winning formula which, by the way, contributed to earning the prestigious Autobest Award from a panel of journalists of 26 countries in European countries. Here's the launch timing. The four doors is already here. The five doors will hit the market in a couple of months. And a wagon will follow in September, ready by May for order intake. So here we are, March 1st, the due date to deliver on a vision. The vision of a brand where every car stands for something, where every car has a purpose, where every car brings something unique to the market, some vision, and even some fun. Look at the stand. We took a stroke of genius from 1957 and turned it into a global family. We extracted Tipo's DNA and addressed the needs of the ultra-rational post-crisis European consumer. And we gave a beautiful new shape to a 50-year-old dream. So yes, today, my team and I are a little bit like a bunch of new fathers, proud to share their new family with the world. I know what you think. Around the auto show, there are bigger cars, more powerful, more expensive cars. I know, we've got to stay humble, but you see, Fiat is proof that you can be humble and still make a statement. It's proof that you can grow your family tree and still keep it true to its roots. And take it from one awaiting a newborn arrival at home, it's proof that even a little voice can make a big difference. Thank you.